Meanwhile, a magistrate court in Dominica will continue hearing the case against fugitive Indian businessman Mehul Choksi. Choksi, who is now facing charges of illegally entering the Caribbean nation, was earlier produced before the court. India, of course, is aiming to extradite Choksi as a legal battle against him. In fact, a multi-agency team from the country is present in Dominica. Remember, Choksi is wanted in India's $2 billion Punjab National Bank fraud case. However, the fugitive tycoon's lawyer said that Choksi cannot be extradited to India as he is an Antiguan citizen. He also argued that Choksi was abducted from Antigua on May 23rd and brought to neighboring Dominica, where he was tortured.
See, at the moment, it is a habeas corpus petition, so the only question before the court is that whether Mr. Mehul Choksi entered Dominica illegally or not, whether he is liable to be detained or not, whether Dominican police has a right to keep him in custody or not, how will he be deported, where he will be sent, all these are not the questions before the court.
The issue has kicked off a political storm in the Caribbean, with the opposition in both Antigua and Dominica slamming their governments over their handling of the issue. At the center of the legal battle is the confusion over Choksi's citizenship. The Indian government is arguing that Choksi is still an Indian citizen. Choksi had taken up Antiguan citizenship and has been living in the country since 2018. However, the Antiguan Prime Minister, Gaston Browne, has backed Choksi's extradition to India. Our principal diplomatic correspondent Sidhan Sibyl gets you more on this. Listen in.
Wheelchair-bound Mehul Choksi was produced in front of the magistrate court. This is part of the legal formulation here in India as well. We know that in case of a detention, a person needs to be produced in front of a magistrate court within 24 hours. The time period in Dominica is 72 hours. But nonetheless, today will be another day in this long legal battle in which two things will be taken up. One, of course, the petition of habeas corpus. And secondly, of course, the illegal presence of Mehul Choksi in Dominica. We know that this long legal battle is expected to last for some days or some months. As of now, of course, it's a window of opportunity for India to bring back Mehul Choksi, who was involved in the multi-crore PNB bank scam.
Earlier, in an exclusive conversation with We On World, as one Choksi's wife rallied behind her husband, Preeti Choksi hit out at the Antiguan Prime Minister Gaston Browne for backing her husband's deportation to India.
I believe that if the law is followed, he would be sent back to his country, which is Antigua and Barbuda. I would like to just say that we are deeply anguished by his comments, because at the same time, Mr. Gaston Browne has said that do not let him come back to Antigua, because he will be protected by the constitution and laws of Antigua. Why would he be protected by those, by the constitution and laws, if he was not a citizen of Antigua?
Preeti Choksi also broke her silence on the mysterious woman who was with her husband in Dominica. She said that the woman has been untraceable. Remember, the Antiguan Prime Minister had said that Choksi had taken his girlfriend to a romantic trip to Dominica, where he was caught.
Firstly, the picture that is being run of this person called Barbara is not even a correct picture. Where is she? No one knows. If a crime occurred and she saw it, why has she not said anything? No one knows. If my husband was found in Dominica and he has said, and I believe the police have collaborated, that he was kidnapped, where is that kidnapping case filed by the Dominican police?